Hare Krishna. Question: if someone wants to become a brahmachari, how can he develop or increase the taste for academic studies, because those studies are not going to help him in the future on becoming a brahmachari? Answer: our focus in doing our duties should be on doing what is best for the service of Krishna and for our own spiritual advancement. And with respect to a devotee student, the present swadharma is studies. And if we do well in our studies, we set a good example to society of how a devotee also does activities responsibly, competently. And in fact, in studies, if somebody is doing well, that itself can become a very powerful means by which one can attract others to Krishna. And often in India, there is this widespread conception that people who are good for nothing, people who can't do anything well in material life, people who are useless, they become renunciates, they become brahmacharis and sannyasis. So that is a conception which is erroneous, and it is our responsibility that we don't perpetuate that misconception, but rather we help eliminate that misconception. And the way we will eliminate that is by doing our studies well. So we are actually, by doing studies well, helping in the gaining of respect for Sanatana Dharma and for the representatives of Sanatana Dharma by that. So normally when students study, it is just for the sake of their own ego or for the sake of their future career. I want to prove how clever I am, or I want to have a very happy life with a high paying job in future. But a devotee has a higher purpose than that. A devotee studies well to glorify Dharma. And along with that, even for the individual level, the spiritual advancement is not just something that comes by being in a particular ashram. It comes by learning to discipline our mind. And one aspect of disciplining the mind is doing things which the mind doesn't like to do. So that doesn't mean that we have to deliberately make ourselves miserable. But sometimes when our duties do require us to do things which the mind dislikes because of its lethargy, then doing those things can lead to our inner growth, because it gives us the experience of disciplining the mind and of mastering the mind, at least for that time period. So often when a devotee says, I don't want to study because I'm going to become a brahmachari. Now how much is that unwillingness to study, reluctance to study due to an eagerness to be a brahmachari, and how much is it because one is just getting the easy way out? It is the path of least resistance. One doesn't have to apply the mind to a subject which is difficult. So we should know that our spiritual advancement depends on how much we learn to discipline the mind. And even if the specific knowledge that we acquire through our academic studies may not help us in future, but the training in disciplining our mind which we can acquire through our studies will stand us in good stead in our brahmachari life also. And also we should not assume that because I'm going to become a brahmachari, I will become a brahmachari in future. Many things can change, and it is better always that we don't, for the sake of a future, neglect the present. So things may change, somehow circumstances may change, we may not be able to become brahmachari. Even if we become brahmachari, we may not be able to continue as a brahmachari. So it's always good for us to make sure that the opportunities we have presently, we are utilizing them properly. Now, this is not negative thinking. This is not pessimism, to think that I may not be able to become brahmachari. It is just not that utopianism should be allowed to strip us away from the present opportunities that we have. Yes, what will come in the future, I will deal with in the future. But what I have right now, let me use it well. And who knows in future what I study. Suppose I am studying engineering now. And future, who knows, there might be in the temple, there might be a project which may require my engineering knowledge. We do not know what will come in the future. So it is best for us, for the sake of ensuring that people don't think of devotees and especially renunciates as escapists, for the sake of glorifying Dharma, for the sake of disciplining our mind, and for the sake of preparing for our future contingencies, that we do our present duty of studying responsibly and competently. Thank you. Hare Krishna.